It's the largest, or one of the largest, such operations in the whole country when we get this fully implemented. And I think that really helps us think about the future. What are the things that we're going to learn that's going to help us as we think about this over a multi-year period?
Yeah, that's such an important part of this grant, Mark, is, you know, if we got two or three test trucks, you learn a lot, but you don't really exercise your operations, as we know, with three trucks like you do with the 50 that we'll have in El Monte. So think of all the things we'll have to do, how you assign the trucks to the driver, how the drivers interact with charging stations as opposed to diesel fueling locations, how we rotate those trucks through the charging infrastructure to make sure they're ready for each driver that's coming upon shift. All that'll be a really important element. We also know there's operational limitations on battery electric vehicles right now. Now, as the technology gets better, it'll get better, but the range is limited. It's 200 to 250 miles, so we have to make sure we adjust our operations accordingly. And these trucks are heavier, so we also have to account for the loads that we're assigning to these trucks. So there's a lot of operational learnings we're gonna get out of this program.
Rob, I think one of the really neat things about this operation at scale is how we're gonna be applying these battery electric trucks in combination with what?
With our intermodal operations. Right. Absolutely, Mark. And we know, and it's another one of our sustainability goals, is doubling the size of intermodal. So a load on intermodal is only about a third of the emissions that a regular truck is. So you already have this great intermodal savings in emissions, and now we're attaching to the front of it a zero emission dray move. So very exciting from an emission reduction standpoint.
No doubt about it.